like I feel it right now. Because sometimes people are the very ones that will separate you. Come on, your neighbor says, ain't no church hurt worth separating me from my passion. Come on, that's a low one. Say it, say it, say it. Don't let no church hurt separate you from your passion and the destiny that God has on your life. God is trying to pull you into something, and you permitting people. I don't know who I'm preaching to. Who am I preaching to this morning? You let people stop you from God pulling you into your destiny. He has greatness, he has glory for you. He has things that he's trying to do in your life. But what you gonna do? I'm leaving the church. I'm not talking to this church only. This is a kingdom message, because we get folk on the other end. Why are you here, baby? I wasn't getting along with them over there. Take your state book right back over there. You out of the place that God has called you into? Woo! And do what, bring the same old thing over here? Then we're gonna have to deal with that. And you say, people, separate you out of your destiny. You're passionate about God. You're all of that about God. He's doing great things in your life. And then you let somebody do something. Come on, bump your neighbors and people.
People.
Jeremiah says, I ain't gonna do it. I ain't feeling it. You can beat me down, put me at the gate. Everybody can walk by me, talk junk about me. Pastor, you are the chief priest. You the bishop of the house. But even you are not going to separate me from my destiny. Because I am connected to God Almighty. And the fact that I'm connected to God, I know I got to go through some people to get to where God is trying to take me. Come here, Pastor. I ain't got no time for you. If you look in the next verse, I ain't got time to preach it. But the next thing he said, I'm going to call you trouble every time somebody see you. Look at the next verse. We ain't got time to read it. He's like, that's what God has to say about you. Every now and then when somebody come at you with some crazy stuff, you've got to get in your heart and say, that's all right, baby. Come here, let me hug you. Kiss you on both sides of your cheek and let me keep it going. Can you bump your say, let me say, people. They will separate you from the glory that God has for you. Okay, here we go. Let me update it for you. That's Jeremiah in a 7-foot circumference cell, sunk down in mud, looking up at 48 feet, says, I will not let that separate me from what God has for me. Let me show you this. Media, are you ready? Come on, I want to show you something, and then I'm going to just end this thing right here. Let me show you something.
Play clock at 5. He's intercepted at the goal line by Malcolm Butler. Unreal.
They try to pick play out. They tried to go here, but he beats them to the punch. And I'm sorry, but I can't believe the call.
Me neither.
I cannot believe the call. You've got Marshawn Lynch in the backfield. You've got a guy that's been borderline unstoppable in this part of the field. I can't believe the call.
It's gotta be one of the dumbest calls offensively in Super Bowl history. Okay. You are on the 1-yard line, and you have number 24, and you drop back pass. Are you kidding me?
Let me update it for you. The word on the street is that Coach Pete Carroll don't get along with Marshawn Lynch. The word on the street is that they don't get along together. Because we don't get along, I'm not going to give you the ball. I'm going to let our personality disagreements separate me from the glory of winning a Super Bowl. I'm going to let a mere